Hello, welcome to SS Unitech Social This Side, and this is continuation of SSIS tutorial. So today we gonna discuss about merge transformation. So what is merge transformation? So merge transformation is used to combine two sorted data sets into a single data set. The rows from each data set are inserted into output based on the value in their key columns. It also requires that the merged column in it should have matching metadata. Like if we want to merge two input datasets, column 1 in our dataset 1, in column 1 in dataset 2, these two should have the matching data types. We cannot use the more than two datasets. This is our case 1 where we need to use sort transformation. Second, we will understand without using sort transformation, because sort transformation is fully blocking transformation. So we need to avoid if we can. So here we can see we have two input sheets. Sheet 1 contains the information of male employees. Second, sheet 2 contains the information of female employees. So we want to merge and load in our OLEDP destination. So let's have a look of input sheets. So this is our male employees. As we can see, it has employee ID, name, gender and salary. We have total 4 columns. Go to on female employees. Here again we have employee ID, name, gender and salary. So we have total 4 columns. So we want to merge these two sheets data and upload in our OLEDB destination. So let's have a look of SQL Server table where we want to load the data. So this is our merge statement table. So initially we don't have any data. If we can execute our first query, then we can see we don't have any data, and it also contains the 4 columns. First is employee ID, second name, gender and salary. So we have total 4 columns. Now go to on SSDT to implement this package. Here we need to add one more package. So right click on this SSIS package and create a new package. And then we need to rename with merge. We are going to use sort, so we can use sort. Now inside this control flow panel we need to use data flow task, so we can drag and drop this data flow task and double click on this data flow task. So here we need to configure our source, transformation and destination. Our source is Excel file, so we need to use Excel source. Double click on this Excel source. Excel source editor window will be open. So here we need to make the connection manager. Here we need to select the Excel file path. So go to on merge. First of all, I am going to make connection with male employees. Click on open. Click on OK. Here we need to select the Excel sheet. So sheet 1, it contains the data. So we need to select the sheet 1. Go to on columns. We want all the column. Then click on OK. So we have done with male employees. We can rename this Excel source with male. Second, we need to configure for female. So we can rename with female. Now double click on this female. Here we need to make one more connection for female employees. Select the file, click on open, then OK. Again we need to select Excel sheet. Sheet 1 contains the data. Go to on columns. We want all the column. Click on OK. So we have done our source. Now we need to configure our transformation. So here we need to use sort transformation, but I am not going to use sort transformation at yet. I am going to use directly merge. If we can drag and drop merge, then we can see over here we have down arrow and up arrow. It shows that we need to use sorted input. If we are going to use unsorted input, this is for merge 1, click on OK. For merge 2, if we can click, then we can see error message. It shows me that the input merge 1 and input merge 2 has sort key position assigned to their columns incorrectly. It means we need to use sort transformation to sort the input data. So I am going to use sort transformation. So we can drag and drop sort transformation for male and female as well. then we can connect with male and female. Now we need to double click on this sort transformation for male. Here we need to sort with employee ID and click on OK. Then double click on this female. We want to sort with employee ID, then again click on OK. So now we have sorted input data for male and female as well. Now I am going to use merge transformation. So we can connect with merge input 1. Here we can see we don't have option for input 3. We have option only for input 1 and input 2. So it has the limitation where we cannot use more than 2 inputs. So as we can see, error has been gone. Once we double click on this, then we can see we have output column name, merge input 1 and merge input 2. So we are okay with it. Now we need to configure our destination. So our destination is OLEDB destination. So we can drag and drop OLEDB destination and connect with merge. Now double click on this OLEDB destination. So OLEDB destination editor window has been opened. We need to make the connection manager. So as we have already made the connection, so I am going to use that one. Here we have merge statement table. So this is our merge statement table. Go to unmapping. So mapping succeed. Now click on OK. So initially we don't have any data as we have displayed. Now execute our package. As we can see, 19,000 rows has been inserted in our table. If we can execute our select statement, then we can see 19,932 rows has been inserted. This is our case 1. So in our case 2, without using sort transformation. So here we can sort data at source by using its sorted property through and set sort key position. So how we can implement? Create one more package, SSIS package, new SSIS package. Here we need to rename our package with merge. So here we need to drag and drop our data flow task, then double click on this data flow task. Now we need to configure our source, transformation and destination. So our source is Excel source, so we can drag and drop Excel source. Double click on this Excel source, click on new, we can browse and select for main. We can click on OK. Now we can select our Excel sheet, sheet 1, go to on columns. We want all the columns, click on OK. Now we can right click on this show advanced editor. Here we have input output properties. Here we have an option for is sorted. We can select this property with true. Once we click on true, then go to on output columns. In this column we need to set the sort key position. Sort key position should be 1. Click on OK. For female employees, we need to make connection, browse, female, click on open. OK. Now we need to select our Excel sheet, sheet 1, go to on columns, we are OK with it. Now again, then show advanced editor, input output properties, Excel source output. Here we need to select this is sorted with true. Then we can expand output columns, employee ID, sort key position should be 1. Then click on OK. So now we are getting the data in sorted at source. So we can use this. Now we can use our merge transformation. Drag and drop this merge transformation for male. This is merge input 1. Click on OK. Then merge input 2. As we can see, double click on this merge and we are getting the output column name merge input 1 and merge input 2. We want load this data in our OLEDB destination. So we can set up our OLEDB destination. Now we can connect with merge. Double click on this, click on new. As we have already made the connection, so I am going to use that one. And again, we are going to use data in mass transformation table. Go to unmapping, mapping succeed, click on OK. So we have done our package. Now go to on SSMS. Here we need to truncate our table. So as we can see, we don't have any data in this table. So I am going to execute this package. So package has been executed successfully. Now we can stop this package, go to on SSMS, and we can execute our select statement. As we can see, 19,932 rows has been inserted successfully in our table. So this is our case 2. So I hope you have understand how we can use the merge transformation with sort transformation and without using sort transformation. So thank you so much for watching this video. If you like this video, please subscribe our channel to get many more videos. Thank you so much.